You're back with DJ Smooth, and we're gonna sit back and take it easy while I take you guys on a ride down Rhythm Road.
No, I'm just kidding, guys. Welcome back to R&R Reviews. This is our second audio recording review to date. Make sure you leave a comment about your thoughts on the film and review. And as always, like our Facebook page and make sure you subscribe to our YouTube page. As previously stated, this review will contain no spoilers. With that being said, let's jump right on into this week's review on It Chapter 2. We gave It Chapter 2 an overall rating of 7.7 out of 10 points. We described it as a horror movie finally worth recommending. Horror movies are a dime a dozen, but it truly takes something different to grab us with the genre and delivers it in every area. This is of course based on the classic Stephen King novel of the same title. This sequel would be what is the second half of the book written by Mr. King. Our story follows the Losers Club 27 years after the events of the first film. Don't worry though, if you're not familiar with the first film, this great piece of cinema will help catch you up on it. There are tons of flashbacks and connections to the adolescent versions of our characters. The film pretty much fills in any questions you could have as it plays out. As I was saying, the losers are brought together once again to deal with the shape-shifting It. They all return from their new lives to come and face their ultimate fears. It's hard to talk any more about the storyline without giving up any spoilers, but we can say that this film is taken well beyond the horror genre. It carries a much deeper story about conquering fear and dealing with the guilt of our past, all while emotionally connecting to these characters and their intertwining relationships. At moments it scares you and makes you cringe, but overall, the sentimental story takes us through so much more. Our characters are constantly developing and changing throughout. All seven of them have their own arcs that we follow throughout the movie. This film is not worried about rushing into anything. It takes its time and allows the film to be driven by the characters. With a 2 hour and 49 minute runtime, you would expect the film to grow dry, but honestly, instead it continues to draw you and build suspense as you reach the climax. These phenomenal characters would be nothing without the exceptional cast that plays them though. Every single cast member chosen was done so in perfection. They look, sound, and feel like the same characters. They even share similar mannerisms. The casting director deserves a lot of credit here for some grade A work. Our standout performances definitely go to James McAvoy and Bill Hader. Although everyone in this film gave depth and convincing performances, these two stood way above that level. Let us not also forget about the extremely talented Bill Skarsgård. He's extremely creepy and at points just downright scary. He has taken this antagonist and brought it to a whole new level that's not just evil, but truly sinister in his unmerciful slaughter of children and adults alike. The score impacts this film in such a solid manner. Horror films rely on a score, or the lack thereof, more than other genres to truly bring suspense, fear, and a thrilling sense to the film. This film also gives a great soft sentimental score that brings together the softer moments. There were a few points where the CGI did seem sloppy, and it could have been a bit stronger in its use of practical effects. That being said, this film had a much larger load to carry in this area. There was a lot more of the It scenes than in its predecessor, so they needed a lot more CGI. Overall, these scenes were done well and gave us a real enough feel to stay engaged. This is the horror movie you want to see. It is the highest rated horror film R&R has recommended yet. It touches all the areas it should to create a truly profound cinematic expression. It is so much more than simple jump scares and gore. Its inner story sends a deep message that all can relate to. Andy Muschietti, which I'm probably pronouncing wrong, has given us, in our opinion, the best Stephen King adaptation to date. Well guys, that's our review on It Chapter 2. Until next time, we'll see you later. Remember, it's a beautiful day in the cinema hood.